whether theft is an offense involving empty. Empty na artham empty edikkalaya or altered. So now we should decide whether theft is an offense. Theft is equal to offense. How do we know theft is equal to offense? Section 378 of IPC says that theft is an offense. So section 378 of Indian Penal Code says theft is an offense. Next. Whether theft is an offense involving moral turpitude. That is the next question. Whether theft is an offense involving moral turpitude, that is the next question. So now what you will say? To do an act of theft, to do an act of theft means the person is dishonest. To do an act of theft means the person is dishonest. So therefore, theft is equal to an offense involving moral turpitude. Therefore, theft is equal to an offense involving moral turpitude. See, closely follow. How we are discussing? First, we are discussing whether theft is an offense, and we are discussing. Once we determined that theft is an offense, then we are determining whether theft is an offense involving moral turpitude. Are you all with me?
Yes,
see, there can be some circumstances where there may be an offense, but it may not include moral turpitude. For example, what happens when I was going on the roadside, by mistake I dashed against a person, that person is serious in hospital. This is an offense, sir. Is this an offense? Yes. For this also some punishment is prescribed. Are you all with me? But whether is this an offense involving moral turpitude? This is not an offense involving moral turpitude. Are you all getting my point? But this is a separate condition. This is a separate condition. Both these conditions are to be cumulatively satisfied. Next case. X Limited is there. Mr. A is the employee of X Limited. Mr. A is the employee of X Limited. Now friends, what happened? Because of Mr. A's negligence, X Limited made a loss. X Limited made a loss of rupees 8 lakhs. Because of the negligence of this person, X Limited made a loss of rupees 8 lakhs. Then, however, Mr. A was not terminated as he was due for retirement. Mr. A was not terminated as he was due for retirement in another 1 year. When he retired in another 1 year, the employer tried to adjust this loss against the gratuity. The employer tried to adjust this loss against the gratuity. Tell me friends, is that possible?
No.
Is that possible?
No.
No, it is not possible. why it is not possible? Because termination is not as a result of negligence. Termination is not as a result of negligence. I'll write it here now. But as a result of superannuation. But as a result of superannuation. X Limited is there. X is an employee of X Limited. X Limited has given free residential accommodation to Mr. X. Why it has given free residential accommodation to Mr. X? It can be occupied till his service. Which means as long as service is there, this person, he can occupy that premises. Now friends, listen here, what happens? Mr. X got terminated or superannuated. And he continues in that accommodation. For 6 months, and he continues in that accommodation for 6 months, resulting in loss of rent to the company. Resulting in loss of rent to the company. Whether this loss of rent can be adjusted against the gratuity? Whether this loss of rent can be adjusted against the gratuity? Yes or no?
Yes.
Friends, yesterday itself I told you that yes, this can be adjusted because Supreme Court has given such a decision. Come on, friends.
Yes, sir.
If you logically interpret this with the previous case, you can come to a conclusion that termination is not as a result of super. Termination is not as a result of this act, willful omission or negligence. Termination is as a result of superannuation. Thereby, this should not be adjusted. We may come to a conclusion. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
But Supreme Court in its decision, it has given that yes, this can be adjusted. Maybe because the Supreme Court found that this person already superannuated, thereby there is no scope for terminating this person again, but still some of the gratuity is to be recovered. Loss of rent should be recovered. Thereby Supreme Court might have ordered like this. Are you all following?
Yes, sir.
So anyways, whatsoever it can be, one Supreme Court it gives a judgment, then it is binding for us, and this is even more binding for us because this is there in our institute study material. X Limited is there. X is his employee. X Limited is there. X is the employee of X Limited. Now what happened? X Limited has given a property on lease to Mr. X. X Limited has given a property on lease to Mr. X. Mr. X refused to surrender that property. Mr. X refused to surrender such a property. Tell me, friends, whether gratuity can be forfeited, or can gratuity be held as a lien? You understand what is meant by lien, no? Lien is very simple, sir. I'll give you a small example. For example, our Prasanna Venkatesh is there. Mr. Prasanna Venkatesh is promising you all a treat. For some reason, he is promising you a treat. And he is not giving you the treat. Now, what you people do? You take the bike key of Prasanna Venkatesh and you say, Prasanna, until you give us treat, we will not give this bike key. Now, what is this? This is called as exercising lien. Until you do that, I will not release something. Your property, I will not release. This is what you call as a lien. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Can I hold gratuity as a lien? No, that is not possible. So, whether is this possible? No, this is not possible. Gratuity is an asset or not? First, you should ask for whom? Employer ke? Employer ke? Employee ke? Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now listen. Let us take Mr. Ram Prakash is there. Ram Prakash is such a brilliant fellow. Assume. He is such a brilliant fellow. Very good person until the clock strikes 6 o'clock in the evening. Once clock strikes 6 o'clock in the evening, Ram Prakash, he should go and stand before a shop. He should purchase something and then he should put fuel for his body. See, friends, I am not questioning the character of Ram Prakash, but once he is drunk, then nobody can assess the character of Ram Prakash. So what he used to do? Once he is drunk, then he used to steal. Once he used to steal, he used to do murder. Like this, many things are there. Now, listen. What happened? Ram Prakash got an excellent wife, intelligent wife. Because always, opposite poles will attract, no?
Yes,
thereby Ram Prakash got an intelligent wife. Now, what happened? That wife, what she used to do? That wife, na many wife, land, ore wife da. What she used to do? She gave a direction or she made a request to the employer. What request she should make to the employer? Sir, don't give the salary to Ram Prakash in cash. Directly transfer the salary to my bank account. So the employer also, what he did, transferred this to Ram Prakash's wife bank account. Response, friend.
Yes,
up and now Ram Prakash is having a very big difficulty. What is the big difficulty? He is not having money for the purpose of adding fuel to his body. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now you see, there is a Seji. You know, no? Ronak. Ronak is there. He is a Seji. You know who is a Seji? No, Marwari.
Yes, sir.
One who lends loan. You know them, no?
Yes, sir.
Now, Ronak. Ram Prakash goes to Ronak. And he is asking to Ronak, Ronak, will you give me a loan? No, first he is asking like this, Ronak, will you sponsor for one day? Ronak is saying, no, no, friendship is different, money is different. Ronak is saying, are, instead of giving you a treat, I'll give you a loan. But what security you will give? Ram Prakash should give some asset to Mr. Ronak, yes or not?
Yes, sir.
I have, Ram Prakash is saying, Ronak, I am not having any asset in my hand, but I am having a future asset. I am having a future asset. What is that future asset? Gratuity I am having. I will keep that gratuity as a, I will pledge that gratuity. I will charge that gratuity. I will assign that gratuity. Abhin Ram Prakash is telling to Ronak. Are you all following?
Yes,
now what Ram Prakash can do? Can he pledge? Can he assign? Can he charge?
No, sir.
He can do, but such an act is void. Such an act is
void.
Our friends, look at the intention of the legislature. What is the intention of the legislature? Gratuity should be made available only at the time of retirement to take care of the last few days of the employee and his spouse. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
This appears to be the primary intention. That is why law has provided gratuity shall not be assigned, gratuity shall not be charged. Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
But this we cannot stop. What we cannot stop? Suppose Ram Prakash is retiring or he is terminating from that office. Now he is receiving gratuity in cash. Come on, yeah.
Yes, sir.
That gratuity amount he can give it to some other person, that we cannot stop. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
What is that we are saying? Before that gratuity could be paid to Mr. Ram Prakash, this gratuity cannot be charged, this gratuity cannot be assigned, this gratuity cannot be pledged.